Now on 18 Eyewitness News.
Missouri State Troopers explains why Missouri traffic fatalities are on the rise. A Southeast Missouri woman faces murder charges in the death of her stepmother. Plus, Dr. Sunil Chan joins us on Ask the Expert. All of these stories, sports, and storm tracker weather only on 18 Eyewitness News.
Coverage you can count on. This is 18 Eyewitness News.
Thanks for joining us, everyone. I'm Fred Dawkins, and here are the top stories that we're working on for you at this hour. Traffic fatalities in Missouri are up by 14% in 2012 compared to this time last year. When Trooper Justin Wheatley of the Missouri State Highway Patrol visited the 18 Eyewitness News studios in Farmington, he told us the major factor is distracted driving.
And what people are doing, common trend, is being distracted, run off the road, overcorrect, and it causes them to get out of control, lose control of the vehicle, crossing over the center line, hitting other vehicles head on. The biggest cause is just distraction, you know, inattentive driving.
Trooper Wheatley says while cables separating traffic lanes going in opposite directions have reduced crossover accidents, they have created another issue, and that's speeding drivers.
In the crossover areas and stuff, that the cables have helped in that area. However, it's really hindered us in a way, because now people, you know, they're driving faster. They're not so concerned about, you know, losing control, crossing over and hit somebody, and they're driving faster, so now the speeds have picked up.
Trooper Wheatley adds the patrol is looking at better ways to catch speeders since there are only limited areas where they can hide along the highway. Well, now Dustin Kopp is here with a look at our first forecast into the week. Dustin?
Good evening, Fred. Good evening, everybody. Today turned out to be a decent day here in Southeast Missouri. Low 90s for highs and plenty of sunshine. Currently here in Southeast Missouri, temperatures are on the warm side, but not too bad out there. 91 right now in Festus, 89 in St. Genevieve and Fredericktown. A little cooler as we head south in Cape Girardeau at 87, 88 in Van Buren and Poplar Bluff right now at 88 degrees. As we go through the evening hours, clear skies for the most part, 85 degrees by 7 p.m., 77 by 9, and by midnight, we'll see a temperature around 69 degrees. It's going to be a nice evening this evening. We'll give you all those details, plus tomorrow's forecast and a chance of some cooler weather in the long-range forecast. All those details coming up later in weather.
A Culin, Missouri woman will stand trial for her role in conspiring with family members to kill her stepmother more than 12 years ago. 38-year-old Melissa Jo Austin Baggett was bound over to Circuit Court by Associate Judge John Bloodworth at the end of her preliminary hearing last week. Baggett will appear August 21st before presiding Circuit Judge Michael Pritchett for arraignment on charges of second-degree murder. Now, Baggett is one of four charged in connection with the August 1999 death of her stepmother, Carla Ann Austin. Authorities believe Carla was killed in retaliation by members of her late husband's family who held her responsible for his death. Almost 600 St. Francis County students are better prepared for a successful school year, thanks to this past Saturday's back-to-school fair at the Central High School Fieldhouse. Young Faith in Christ hosted this year's event when our 18 Eyewitness News cameras caught up with YFC Executive Director Marcus Archer at the fair. He told us the outpouring of assistance from the community was remarkable.
All the coupons we had donated for families, which were Walmart cards and food coupons from restaurants, and all the people giving away school supplies and all that, I'd say we're looking at about 40 to 50, at least, different businesses or organizations or groups or churches that's involved with this. So and I may be short there. It's been a lot of people, and it's going pretty good so far.
The St. Francis County Back to School Fair gave out supplies to 570 children this past Saturday. That's an increase from 540 last year. The 2010 Democratic challenger for Missouri's 8th U.S. Congressional District has a new job at the Department of Veterans Affairs. Tommy Sowers was confirmed late last week by the Senate to serve as the Assistant Secretary for Public and Intergovernmental Affairs at that department. Sowers is a Rolla native and Army veteran who served in Iraq and Kosovo. When he ran against Republican Joanne Emerson 2 years ago, he lost, receiving less than 29% of the vote. Sowers had previously taught at the U.S. Military Academy at West Point and at the Missouri University of Science and Technology. When we come back on 18 Eyewitness News, a very successful 139th annual St. Francis County Fair wraps up. That story coming up only on 18 Eyewitness News.
When you're looking for quality home furnishings, appliances, and more, look no further than Heartland Furniture and Appliance. Heartland Furniture and Appliance offers great low prices every day and 6 months same as cash financing. No hassle leasing and great customer service. With three locations to better serve you, the customer. In Donovan, Dexter, and Piedmont on both sides of Main Street. Heartland Furniture and Appliance.
Sing a song about the Heartland.
Take control of your future by enrolling at the Unitech Career Center. Discover a new career with Unitech's nursing programs or the opportunities with Unitech's sheet metal fabricating program, or turn your hobby into a career with Unitech's power sports equipment program. From electrical trades to automotive technology programs, the first step to a well-paying future starts at the Unitech Career Center, Raider Road in Bon Terre. For adult information, call 358-3011. For high school information, call 358-2271.
You're watching 18 Eyewitness News with Fred Dawkins, Chief Weathercaster Dustin Kopp, and Jeremy Martin with sports. 18 Eyewitness News continues.
Folks from across southeast Missouri streamed into the St. Francis County Fairgrounds this weekend to enjoy the final days of the 139th annual County Fair. Clear skies and warm temperatures for most of the week made this one of the best attended fairs in recent memory. Among this year's highlights was Friday night's Trent Tomlinson concert, produced and sponsored by Froggy 96 and the Dawkins Broadcast Group, and Saturday's truck and tractor pulls. Throughout the week, folks enjoyed the 4-H and FFA projects, the animals, as well as the food, fun, and carnival rides. The Missouri Department of Conservation is awaiting test results to help determine why a number of elk have died recently. Since mid to late July, 6 cow elk, 1 yearling bull elk, along with 3 calves were all found dead. The animals were relocated earlier this year from Kentucky to Missouri's Elk Restoration Zone in Carter, Shannon, and Reynolds counties. Scientist Lonnie Hansen says preliminary test results have not pointed to one specific cause of death. However, a combination of stress from relocation, extreme heat, and drought conditions appear to have been contributing factors. Hansen says while stress could be catching up to some of the 2012 elk, the 2011 herd appears to be doing well overall despite the heat and the drought. Authorities discovered a suspected shake-and-bake meth lab in a truck in the Walmart parking lot in Poplar Bluff late last week. Officers found the lab after responding to an alarm at an adjacent business Wednesday evening. Shortly before 8 o'clock, Poplar Bluff Police Chief Danny Whiteley and Sergeant Aaron Decker responded to an alarm at the Gift Chest Jewelers in Poplar Bluff. After making sure the business was secure, Decker noticed 26-year-old Christopher Robinson of Kulin, who he thought had outstanding warrants, standing next to a dark pickup in front of Walmart. Upon investigation, they arrested Robinson and the truck's driver, 25-year-old Sarah McFall of Donovan, on suspicion of possession of a controlled substance, possession of drug paraphernalia, and manufacture of a controlled substance. Both Robinson and McFall were later released pending lab results. And when we come back, Dr. Sunil Chan joins us on Ask the Expert.
Some cooler weather is on the way for southeast Missouri. I have all the details coming up next in weather.
When someone comes in a mental area's emergency department, our focus is giving them the best treatment in the quickest manner possible. We track every single patient, sending the doctors information before they even walk in the room. We have dedicated X-ray and CT equipment in our emergency department. We don't have to waste any time running all over the hospital. We know that minutes count in an emergency, and you can count on ER Plus at Mineral Area Regional Medical Center.
Now, here's your Storm Tracker 18 weather forecast with Chief Weathercaster Dustin Kopp.
And welcome back. Another nice day here in southeast Missouri. We saw a lot of nice weather over the weekend. We saw some thunderstorms through southeast Missouri, but it turned out to be a nice weekend overall. Here in southeast Missouri, look at our weather headlines. Much nicer weather is in store for the next several days. A little bit warmer tomorrow, but then we're going to start seeing a cool down, and we do see that chance of an isolated thunderstorm or two possible for Thursday. Here in southeast Missouri, it's nice out there, not too bad. 87 right now in Cape Girardeau, 89 right now from St. Genevieve through Fredericktown and down to our south in Poplar Bluff at 88 degrees, 88 in Piedmont, 89 in Ironton, and 91 right now in Festus. Here at the studio, we have current temperature of 87 under a sunny sky. Feels like 87 out there. Not too bad out there at all. Dew point 57, 34% humidity, and an east-northeast wind at 5 miles per hour. Going through the day tomorrow, some isolated showers and thunderstorms to the upper Midwest through Kansas. We are going to be in the clear for plenty of sunshine. A little bit warmer tomorrow than it was today, but it's stuff we can handle. Low tonight, around 60 degrees, clear skies, light to variable winds. 61 in Festus, 62 in St. Genevieve and Ironton. Down in Van Buren, 63, Ellington, 63, 67 in Poplar Bluff. Then for tomorrow, we're going to see another nice day. A little bit warmer, as I was saying, 96 degrees. 96 in Festus and Potosi, pretty much 96 everywhere. Down to our south in Poplar Bluff, 94 and 95 in Piedmont. The next several days are looking like this through southeast Missouri. Not too bad out there. Temperatures are going to start cooling down a bit. On Wednesday, high of 92, partly sunny skies, chance of isolated thunderstorms on Thursday with a high of 91. And then look at that, we're into the 80s for Friday and Saturday, sunny skies, and then low 80s by Sunday with isolated thunderstorms, scattered thunderstorms and showers, moving to the forecast on Monday with a high of 86. As we look at our weekend forecast, once again, we're going to see a temperature around 88 degrees on Saturday with a low around 66, partly sunny skies, and then a chance of showers and thunderstorms on Sunday with a high around 84 degrees. Not too bad coming up in the next several days. So let's check out your Storm Tracker weather forecast. More details to look at froggy96online.com. Just click on the weather tab. Fred, back to you.
Dustin, thanks a lot. And now Fred Dawkins Jr. is in the studio with Ask the Expert.
On today's edition of Ask the Expert, we talk with Dr. Sunil Chan of Chan's Medical Office about hypertension.
Hypertension is a term used to describe high blood pressure. Essential hypertension means that the cause of blood pressure is not known. Blood pressure means the force against the walls of your arteries as your heart pumps blood through the body. Blood pressure readings are usually given as two numbers, for example, 120 over 80. One or both of these numbers can be too high. The top number is called the systolic blood pressure, and the bottom number is called the diastolic blood pressure. Many factors can affect your blood pressure, including how much water and salt you have in your body, the conditions of your kidney, nervous systems, or blood vessels, the level of different body hormones. You have a high risk of high blood pressure if you are African American, are obese, are often stressed and anxious, drink too much alcohol, more than one drink per day, for a woman and two drinks for a man, eat too much salt in your diet, have a family history of high blood pressure, have diabetes, smoke. Most of the time, there are no symptoms. In most people, high blood pressure is found when they visit their healthcare provider and have their blood pressure checked. Because there are no symptoms, people can develop heart disease, kidney problems without knowing they have high blood pressure. If you have severe headaches, nausea, vomiting, confusion, changes in your vision, or nosebleeds, you may have severe and dangerous forms of high blood pressure called malignant hypertension.
If you have a question you would like to ask one of our experts, log on to frog96online.com and click Ask the Expert.
Coming up in today's Your Life segment on 18 Eyewitness News, what's the most important thing you should do if you're planning to get married? Find out today on Focus on the Family with Dr. Bill Meyer.
I'm Stacy Johnson. Summer fun often leads to sunburn and an expensive trip to the drugstore. But don't spend that cash when a potato might do the job. Home remedies for sunburn just ahead on Money Talks News.
Your health is brought to you by Parkland Health Mart Pharmacy. Parkland Health Mart Pharmacy of Deloge. We're caring for you and about you is our business. From taking time to explain your medication, offering a caring touch, to a full line of medical equipment, supplies, and diabetic shoes. We'll help you understand your options and assist you with Medicare drug plan enrollment. With a comfortable waiting area, convenient drive-through, or free delivery, caring for our neighbors is our business. Your locally owned Parkland Health Mart Pharmacy, just off of Highway 67 at the Deloge exit. When you're recovering from a traumatic injury, the last thing you need is an unexpected bill. Because most health insurers pay only a part of air transport, Archair Medical has a solution, the Omni Advantage program. For a membership fee of $49 per year, Omni Advantage guarantees you and other covered family members will not have to pay anything that your health insurer doesn't provide. In an extraordinary emergency, the last thing you need to worry about is cost. Contact Archair Medical or visit them on the web to discover all the advantages of Omni Advantage.
Know anyone planning a wedding? Amidst the florist and the caterers, there's another aspect of planning that should not be overlooked. On today's Focus on the Family, psychologist Dr. Bill Meyer explains how couples can prepare for what comes after the wedding.
How would each of you identify kind of what you're expecting as far as how you're going to deal with conflict in your marriage relationship?
Rachel and Nathan have known each other since sixth grade. They fell in love in college, and now they're planning a wedding. But even though they've known each other a lifetime, they still realize the value of premarital counseling.
It's just always good to talk about stuff like this, especially the hard things that Rachel and I might not know a whole lot about just from our dating relationship up to this point.
If anything, it's gotten us to think past the wedding day and just gives us questions to think about. Of what marriage looks like and how to be prepared for that.
The best way to prepare for what comes after the wedding is to identify the different assumptions and expectations that you'll each bring into the marriage.
There's a tremendous value in kind of knowing what to expect and getting rid of some of those hurdles ahead of time. And being different is not the problem. It's just that when you don't appreciate the difference and don't kind of balance and work it out, it becomes an issue later in the relationship.
What can Nathan do, Rachel, that might help you be more inclined to want to deal with it, to bring it out, put it on the table, and talk about it?
By placing those assumptions on the table, premarital counseling exposes issues before they become problems. There are a lot of questions that couples should hash out before the wedding day, such as how will your finances be handled, or how many kids will you have, how will they be raised, even where will you spend Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Things that you wouldn't necessarily want to bring up when you're out on a date sometime, like you don't really want to say, hey, how do you want to deal with conflict mm-hmm. when things get really tough?
Will you really do the dishes
yeah.
after every meal?
All right.
So, I'm Dr. Bill Meyer for Focus on the Family.
For more valuable information on life's issues, relationships, and family, please visit FocusOnTheFamilyTV.com. When you get a sunburn, you want soothing and fast relief, right? Well, some of the quickest and most affordable solutions can be found right in your own home. Money hacker Stacy Johnson explains just what you have in your cupboard.
Summertime and sunburns go hand in hand. But when you get a sunburn, don't blow big bucks at the drugstore. You might find a sunburn solution right at home. Turns out there are lots of home remedies to soothe that sunburn. We spoke with doctors, Search WebMD, Ask Moms. All this stuff is supposed to be able to help. Let's have some fun with our volunteer here and check out some home remedies. First and foremost, you got water. You want to drink it, and if your sunburn's bad, you want to lay in a nice cool bath. Another thing that's supposed to work diluted is milk. Milk's supposed to help. And then, of course, there's baking soda. Baking soda is great for sunburns and all kinds of other stuff. Common cure also, aloe. You can either use it in a bottle like this, or you can actually get an aloe plant, tear off a leaf, and you can use that on your sunburn as well. Supposed to help is a poultice made of oats. You can put that in a bath also, that'll work. And then another thing that people recommend is tea. You can get wet tea leaves, put them directly on the sunburn, or you can put those in a bath. And then finally, believe it or not, the lowly potato is also supposed to help a sunburn. How well these remedies actually work, well, that's a matter of debate. Some might work better than others, but the best way to treat sunburn? Don't get it. Use lots of lotion with an SPF of 30 or higher, and don't get too much sun. Bottom line, don't get sunburned, but if you do, surf over to MoneyTalksNews.com and just do a search for sunburn. For Money Talks News, I'm Stacy Johnson.
And as Stacy said, he's got a lot of information and links at his website. To get there, just go to MoneyTalksNews.com.
And coming up in sports, the Cardinals complete a sweep of the Brewers on Sunday and welcome the Giants to Busch Stadium tonight. The Rams' Brandon Gibson showed off his skills at Saturday's scrimmage, and Mizzou's basketball team is packing their suitcases. These stories and more coming up in sports on 18 Eyewitness News.
Attention, Accutane warning. If you have Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, or inflammatory bowel disease, it may have been caused by the acne drug Accutane. Accutane victims have recently been awarded millions of dollars. Do not delay. There are time deadlines to file a claim.
Call the Relion Group now to be connected with an experienced attorney. There is absolutely no risk on your part. You don't owe us a penny unless we are successful.
Call the Relion Group at 800-698-3105.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now to get the new talking meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs, and they deliver your supplies right to your door for free.
For more information, call 1-800-587-7095.
This is Sports Zone, only on 18 Eyewitness News with Jeremy Martin.
This weekend's 30th anniversary celebration of the 1982 St. Louis Cardinals victory over the Milwaukee Brewers in the World Series was exactly what the Redbirds needed. On Sunday, St. Louis completed the sweep of Milwaukee with a 3-0 shutout. Kyle Loesch led the effort. In six innings, he threw 100 pitches, 67 for strikes, gave up four hits, three walks, and struck out six, raising his record to 12 wins, two losses. The victory gave the Cardinals its 12th win in its last 17 games. This is the first time the club has been 10 games over 500 this season. The San Francisco Giants come to Busch Stadium for a four-game series starting tonight. Jake Westbrook is on the mound for the Redbirds. He'll be opposed by the Giants' Matt Cain. Much of the offseason and camp talk at wide receiver for the St. Louis Rams has centered on draft picks Brian Quick and Chris Givens, as well as the return of Danny Amendola and Greg Salas following season-ending surgeries. However, Brandon Gibson is not ready to step aside. During the scrimmage at the Edward Jones Dome on Saturday, Gibson's job included two sideline catches, one of which was a highlight reel grab to the 3-yard line during a 2-minute drill. Head coach Jeff Fisher is aware of Gibson's skills. He opened training camp as a starting wide receiver along with Amendola and has had a good first week. And the Mizzou basketball team leaves Wednesday for a trip to Europe. The Tigers will tour France, Belgium, and the Netherlands, playing five games before returning August 18th. During a news conference at Mizzou Arena, head coach Frank Haith said he hopes his players will get a little culture while they are there. But he also didn't hide his enthusiasm to see the new-look Tigers compete beyond the practice court and hopefully begin to build a new identity. Missouri returns only three players who have actually played at the school before, and two of those three will not compete in Europe. After missing last season with a torn knee ligament, senior forward Lawrence Bowers has been practicing, but Haith does not want to risk bringing him back too soon. Phil Pressey sprained his knee in practice last week, giving Haith the excuse he was looking for to sit the point guard. And that's a look at sports. Fred and Dustin, back over to you.
Dustin Kopp coming off of a wonderful weekend at the 139th annual St. Francis County Fair. Excellent performance by our star Trent Tomlinson Friday night. It was an awesome attendance for that. And then we went into some rain for the weekend. Cooled things down just a bit and made everybody feel a whole bunch better.
We did. We saw a few rumbles of thunder. Well, I guess heard a few rumbles of thunder. Not saw. We saw some lightning. And we did see the rain fall, but that brought us some cooler weather on Sunday. Turned out to be a nice day. Not a bad day today. And let's take a look at that 7-day forecast. What to expect for tomorrow. We're going to warm up a little bit tomorrow, Fred. A Tuesday high of 96 degrees. Plenty of sunshine. Plenty of sunshine on Wednesday. We're starting to cool things down. Chance of isolated thunderstorms on Thursday. And look at that, Fred. Start of the weekend. Temperatures in the 80s. Lower 80s on Sunday. Some scattered thunderstorms possible. Some scattered showers on Monday of next week. So we're going to start cooling things down. We won't know how to act, Fred.
You know, it's really unusual looking at those temperatures forecast now for August, because typically we're into way up into the 90s for August. Now we're seeing it into the 80s. Could we be seeing a trend to an early fall?
I don't think so, because the trend is starting to look after that 7 days starting to warm back up. So we could only hope, but as far as right now, it looks like after the cool down a little bit for about a week or so, we're going to start warming things back up.
Just when I was ready for fall of the year, you got to go and burst my bubble.
I'm sorry.
Dustin Kopp, thank you.
No
and
problem.
Thank you, folks, for joining us. We'll see you tonight at 10 o'clock with more. Until then, have a blessed evening, and God bless everybody.
Have a good evening, everybody. NewsWatch is next. We'll see you tonight at 10.
Do you see news happening in your neighborhood? Email us at news@kdkz.tv.
Here's what's coming up tonight on KDKZ 18.